Like, you definitely have to take advantage of the situation. We have the CEO of KSC, the one and only Nana Gechaga is live in studio with us. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you.
It's so great to see you. Like, I love the energy in your videos. Oh, it's like, yes, team 5 minutes.
Yes, exactly. Yes.
Yeah. I love the notion behind that. So before we even get into your journey and what exactly you're doing. Just because this could be somebody's 5 minutes right now. What exactly is Team 5 minutes? Because it's a brilliant, brilliant thing.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Well, Team 5 is all about when your alarm clock goes off in the morning.
Yeah.
You have a choice. You either hit the snooze button and go back to sleep.
Yeah.
Or you hit the snooze button again.
Yeah.
And jump up and get out of bed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you hit the snooze button and go back to sleep, most probably you're getting up way later. It's always 2 hours, 3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And basically with that, it's your day is basically gone. You're running up, you're doing catch up, and it's all about missed opportunities.
Yeah.
But if you just get up, hit the snooze, get up, jump into the shower, before you know it,
you're
jamming while you're looking for something to wear, and you start the day on a high.
Yeah.
So that was what Team 5 minutes was all about, because I remember I really struggled with that in university.
Yeah. So sometimes you actually have to take it every 5 minutes as they come.
You're just exactly.
And you have energy to just get up.
Exactly.
All right. Now the energy to shower.
No, exactly. Exactly.
Because some days can be very difficult, Mondays. However, so let's start with what you're doing now, and then we'll get to the very beginning.
Of
right?
course.
So what I love about this, and this is something that is dear to this show, we've always wanted more spaces for young artists, young creatives to be able to showcase their work.
Let me sell myself out before Nana sells me out.
Yeah.
So we met on Tuesday.
Yeah.
My first time to be like on the rooftop of KSC.
Yeah.
Where you can see Nairobi like.
You have not done a photo shoot.
No, man, I haven't done it, man.
I didn't even know.
I've taken photos at KSC, but I've never been to the top where the helipad is and everything.
It's the best.
Yeah, so we had a conversation, and I was like, you know what, you're coming to the show, and Adele is going to question you, because there's our previous governor who sat here and played us.
Because, Nana, what I wanted for Nairobi was, like, so that when a tourist lands, they get a feel of, like, the vibe of the young people, the color that comes with the creatives and things like that, the festivals and, like, you know.
And someone promised us all that. Remember?
Someone promised us all of that. Didn't come to be. So when I saw what you're doing, I was like, "Whew!"
Finally.
Gosh, yeah. Thank you.
So what exactly is it? The program that you're running for artists.
The artists.
Yeah.
Well, that one started off just basically because obviously at KCC, we are refurbishing the inside and also looking at major plans for the outside. So after knocking down a lot of the space on the famous foyer that everyone is talking about.
Yeah.
There was a lot of space. So I figured, well, if we've got a lot of space, what can we use it for?
Yeah.
You can either sell it if you want to for cocktails or any other meetings.
Mm-hmm.
But what had happened is that on my Instagram, I was getting a lot of requests for artists.
Mm-hmm.
Be it the musicians and also the painters.
Yeah.
So walking through one day, I was like, this would be a perfect gallery.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I was like, well, why not? And I was like, you know, the key things is I always believe it's if you can help somebody, help them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we are an organization, we're a business, we are in the business of making money.
Yeah.
But sometimes there's things that are bigger than that. So I was like, we have the space, check.
Yeah.
We're in the city center, check. It's a fantastic platform, and we also have the machinery at KSCC, be it through our social media pages or, support through all of you and everybody out there. So I was like, let's just call it the mini gallery with that and everything. So it's basically every 2 weeks. We started off with 4 artists.
Yeah.
Okay.
But then due to the response, we had over 500 responses. So we expanded the space.
Yeah.
So now it's 8 to 9 artists every 2 weeks. We're in the middle of our second week of our launch of this
project.
And it's been fantastic. And what we also do is it's equipping the artists with the tools. So I even said to them, you may not sell one piece here, but what we will do is we will equip you with a mini video. We will give you the platform where, because again, every week we have 3,000 to 4,000 people coming through KICC to come
yes
to the helipad.
Yeah.
So we're also pushing that. So a lot of people are coming through, and it's been fantastic because it's actually positioning the artist with the right type of client.
Yeah.
And just giving them that, you know, all you need is that little bit of the door.
Yeah.
And it's up to you if you kick it open.
You take it and go, yeah.
And run with it.
And even just the experience, I think.
Yes.
Like the stress of putting together enough pieces to be able to showcase. I think that's good because they've never ever, maybe there's somebody who has just started.
So exactly.
That experience is invaluable. So how can me as an artist who's listening, how do I get my stuff?
Well, all you have to do is email us on md.office@kicc.co.ke.
Mm-hmm.
So, and basically what you have to do is attach some of your artwork, pictures of your pieces, and also just say why you'd like to come.
Yeah.
With that, yeah.
So we're going to post that up on our Twitter page.
Thank you. Those of you
who are just like, MD, what again?
I know, that's why. I'm even trying to speak slow because I know my English is proving to be a bit of a problem.
We got you. It's going up on Kiss 100 Kenya as we speak. But at the same time, I know very many people want to know just your journey. I want to know your journey as well, so getting to where you've gotten to. So we're going to get to that in the next 3 minutes. If you have any questions for Nana, you can send those our way on Twitter. And she is the leader of KICC, doing amazing things for creatives in the industry. So we have the arts project going on, and if you wanted that email address, we've posted it up on kiss100.co.ke on Twitter. I mean, kiss100kenya on Twitter. But we want to know leadership, right? Where it all began for you. Is this something that if we trace back to like high school, primo, like, is this something that was always...
Well, you're CEO of some group.
I think even the playground.
You know,
even in playgroup, I have vivid memories of,
being in charge.
Standing on the climbing frame and shouting down at people, you know, so it's been there for a while.
Yeah.
But I also honestly believe it's about leading it by example.
Yeah.
You know, there's no better way than to actually be there with someone. You can't start selling a dream or selling a vision or anything and you're, you know, hold up in some tower, just watching down and guiding people and telling them what to do. So I think from a very early age, I've always been extremely passionate about Kenya.
Yeah.
Again, also like you say, you know, you've got corporate or you've got, you know, artistic fun.
Yeah.
I make no apologies for being that person who likes to, you know, think out the box.
Yeah.
You know, just that extra.
Yeah.
You know,
Is good.
Yeah, no, it is good. You know, was I ever good at the books? I was, but I had to obviously study really hard for that. But but the person you see here, I've had many lives.
Yeah.
What
were you like? So when we bridge from high school to, let's say, uni, like when you're leaving high school, there's always that like, I'm going to be.
Yes.
So what was your passion point then?
Then was actually sports.
Oh, cool.
Believe it or not, I was a very big athlete back in the day. I actually qualified even for the 96 Olympics for Kenya.
What?
Yes.
Sick. Okay.
With that and stuff. So, yeah. I mean, I used to love basketball, soccer, football, and track, athletics. So with that, I mean, I was always just being like, you know, but as you say, from that time in high school, I also really wanted to be... A game changer, somebody that helps. And it's not for doing it to get something back. It's just, I believe if you're in a position where you can help, then help.
Then help,
It doesn't cost you anything.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, of course, there've always been things, you know, back in the day as a little kid running around, oh, I want to be president. Oh, I want to be a first athlete. Oh, I want to be this. But I think it then kind of narrowed down. It was just like, you know, just be you and do well.
Yeah.
So after, you know, high school, went off to university.
Mm-hmm.
I was in university in the UK. First in the States.
Yeah.
As you are aware, I am a recovering alcoholic.
Mm-hmm.
So my first year in university in America was very rocky. That's where everything kind of all fell apart. And I was able to go to rehab. And from there, 19 years now, not drinking.
Cool.
So that's good.
Yes, yeah.
So 19 years sober.
Yeah.
So after that, then went over to the UK. My first degree was business advertising and marketing.
Mm-hmm.
Second degree was fashion.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, and then after that, but even while I was still in high school, I started my company called Bora Bora, which markets Kenya, and it's with the celebrities. That's how it all started with that, and then from there started doing then the mamas that came here. I know Shafi.
Yeah, first time we
had heard of Shafi, but then you know that's where we actually
that's where we had it running. Yes.
You know, Shafi came, you know, honorary chaperone for Akon and Wyclef, you know, the city tour guide.
Yeah.
He was. But then from there, after that, surprisingly, from there, went into government. So a lot of people didn't know I've been in government actually for quite some time.
Yeah.
But just quiet. I mean, I believe in not really shouting about stuff. Only until recently when people are like, you need to kind of say what it is you do.
Yeah.
So it was just, and it's also about staying in your lane. You know, I know I'm extremely very good at marketing, so that's what I just stick at with that. So yes, so came into government, and then and actually even with the Mamas, it was actually my first time worked with C.S. Balala.
Okay.
So from then, and then now full circle around, he came back into Ministry of Tourism and just worked.
Timing. It was the right timing for it.
Exactly.
And so, like, yours is a very powerful story. What I love is how, because I'm very big on people owning their stories and owning every bit about it. Don't be ashamed about anything, because you don't know who you're inspiring with your story. And also, the two things I've picked up that stand out for me is that, you know, when you're in the States, you had, you know, this battle with alcoholism, went into rehab, but also that you did business and fashion. So it's like the different sides of the world. From that point in time, what has been like the main thing or learning lesson when you look back to that period in time?
Yeah.
What's the one thing you're like, hey, thank God it happened, because if not, I would not have learned A, B, C, D.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I would say it's definitely the battle with the alcohol. It definitely, it builds character.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of strength to you know, actually acknowledge that you have a problem.
Yeah.
Whatever the problem is. And also, again, just from the, I would say that, and also just getting out of it.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just, you know, and I also got a lot of support. There's a real big support here with, you know, the Alcohol Anonymous support groups and everything like that.
Yeah.
You know, still go to them now. You know, just to, you are always in recovery. So I would say that. I think that was a life lesson learned.
Yeah.
And also with that comes regret. My biggest regret is probably, like I was saying, I was an athlete.
Yeah.
I qualified for the 96 Olympics sprinting. And due to drinking heavily at that time, I qualified and I just was like, done it, I've qualified, and didn't go.
Yeah.
And now when you look back on it, I'm just like, you know, that was my time to do service.
Yeah.
You know, so but again, it's about not dwelling on it and moving forward and saying, you know, just from there, what can I now do and move forward
now that I know better.
Exactly.
Yeah. That's really powerful, guys. When we come back, of course, we have Celebrity Quick Fire, but also I do this thing where anybody who's a personality in Kenya, I research. People call it stalk, but I call it research. Your Instagram. So I've been seeing you hanging out with musicians. So I'm just like, something working. What's going to be coming from KCC in that regard? So that's coming up in the next 4 minutes. Thanks to you. You're hanging out with me, Adele Onyango and Shafi Weru. We have Nana Gechaga live in a studio, CEO of KICC. Joyce Humphrey is saying, are you by any chance going to support poets in the society? That would be dope to like have some sort of open mic or something for poets as well.
Definitely. I mean, we're going to be covering all artists.
Mm-hmm.
So again, we're now just, as we're saying, doing the painters and photographers.
Mm-hmm.
But there is something in the pipeline that'll be for the musicians / poets.
Mm-hmm.
So watch this space.
Yeah.
And I'm very excited about that.
Yeah. So that's going to be coming soon.
Yes.
But another thing that we've been talking about, and we were talking about just before you came in, was the World Cup, and everybody has their teams ready. But KICC is not being left behind, right?
No. Nope.
So what are the plans for World Cup starting Thursday?
Yes.
Yeah.
So tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow. Yes.
Opening ceremony starts at 4.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So with that, it's basically, again, like I said, we've got the space, so why not utilize it?
Yeah.
So again, we've partnered up with some other companies, obviously, with that. And then now for 1 month, every day, starting tomorrow from 2 o'clock p.m. until 1 a.m., we've got big screens, stadium style with setup, bleachers, the setup, all of that. Food, there'll also be alcohol being sold. But like I said, as KCC, we're no nonsense in terms of underage drinking. So ID'd at the gate.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, it's just, for me, I don't, like I said, I'm a real sports fanatic. So this is perfect.
Yeah.
And it doesn't get any bigger than World Cup.
Yeah.
And just that excitement, you know, and like I said, you can be watching at home with a few people, or you can be coming down to KICC and watching with thousands of
people. Yeah.
So that was just the whole thing. And it's about also giving back. You know, why not?
And you'll feel like you're in that stadium. Can you imagine?
Exactly. And we've also got a lot of giveaways. Yeah. We've got a lot of support even from the embassies. Mm-hmm. So people, so your ticket, it's 300 shillings.
Yeah.
But it does translate into two Coca-Cola, well, not Coca-Cola, but two sodas on the spot.
Yes. Yes.
And then also your ticket is heavily loaded, because with that you have a chance of entering into the daily raffles,
mm-hmm.
be it a trip to London.
Yeah.
It could be some merchandise from our sponsors. It could be lunch with the CEO of KICC. Yeah. It's just whatever, but it's fully, fully loaded.
Yeah.
So with that, so really looking forward to that.
So we can just come to KICC to get our tickets? Or
you,
can we?
For walk, obviously for the 300, you just come in and just pay at the mm-hmm. gate and come through.
Yeah.
We also do have a VIP section with that, and that is now... We're going to be giving out VIP cards,
mm-hmm.
as you saw yesterday on, and I have to say it was hilarious.
Yes,
Shafi caning Mike with the DJ CK comment, but story for another day. But that whole caption, this.
Yeah.
So we're actually going to even just take that even further, so people will be able to win regular tickets and VIP.